Hey there, it's Cassie. Welcome back to my YouTube channel and blog. Today I have a card that I wanted to show you guys, and it's a little bit longer video, but just hold tight. I feel like it's kind of worth it. There's a lot of techniques going on here, and I think at the end you'll hopefully be satisfied with what you learned today. I made this card for a couple different challenges, and it uses a stamp set that I have used before, but I don't know, I think you'll enjoy it, I hope. So I didn't get the very first bit of video for some reason. I thought I hit record and I didn't. And you're gonna see me going a million miles an hour here, but I am using those distress inks again. And in my last video, I talked about how versatile they are. Well, here's another technique for you. It's called ink blending. And these inks usually blend so beautifully. I'm actually using Bristol Smooth watercolor paper. And they tend to blend just beautifully on this Bristol paper. You can see it's a little bit splotchy, and all I'm doing is just going over and over and over again using three different colors. I'm using Carved Pumpkin is the orange, Wilted Violet is the purple color, and Pickled Raspberry is the pink. And see, that's where I missed it. I didn't get for my greens there. And those greens are Crushed Olive and Mowed Lawn. I'm spritzing them with water right now because they're reactive inks, and you'll see, look at that, it has that really cool effect. So I'm doing something here. I wanted to show you a new technique. If you look at that die, it has a cut edge, and so that particular die has an edge that cuts the grass exactly as big as the die, but I don't want that, so I'll show you a trick. What I do is I line the die up where I want to use it, and then I use some low-tack tape to hold it down and in place. I place it on my cutting plate and I line the top cutting plate edge just before the cut edge that I don't want. And when the die is run through, you should only get the cut grass where you want it, as you saw. Here I'm taking my bit of Bristol watercolor paper, which started out as a 9x12, but I cut that down to 5 1/4 by 12 inches, and that's what I did the ink blending on. And now I am scoring it at 4 inches on each side and just kind of using my bone folder to make sure that crease is good. And that way it'll make the card itself a 5 1/4 by 4 inch card. And I'm taking my grass pieces, which originally those two pieces were cut from that Bristol, and one of them was a 2 inch by 12 inch, and the other was a 1 3/4 by 12 inch. And I'm just taping that down, and you'll see me kind of moving the paper back and forth just to make sure that it will close pretty good. And I peeled it off there because I thought, well, you know what, I can see that edge there right along where the fold is. I need a little bit of the ink just to make sure it's not like a stark white. So I take that Crushed Olive and I put it back in there, and now I'm gonna put some more tape back on my cardstock and put that grass back down where it was, folding it here just to kind of make sure that it'll close where I put it in. Because, you know, you want it to fit in nicely into an envelope. So I'll put some tape back on there, and then I'm going to hold the paper up at a fold at an angle so that I get it exactly where I want it. I end up having a little bit left off, and so I just kind of trim that off with my scissors. And the same process, I'm just going to go ahead and adhere the rest of the grass, the bigger stuff in the back and the shorter stuff up front, just to give it a little bit more dimension. Now that it's all folded nicely, you can see. I like how it turned out. I think it's a nice background. Okay, now this toy, oh my goodness, I love it. So it's a new stamp positioning tool to me. My mom and her husband, Mick, got that for me as a gift, and this is my first time using it, and I'm telling you, I'm loving it. So I used some Memento Tuxedo Black ink, and I stamped my images, which those images are from the Showers and Flowers Simon Says Stamp. And I am going to Copic color them. And I did that on some Express It by Copic paper. And the Copics that I grabbed are E50 and E53 to color the bunny. And no special, just wherever I think that the shadows might land, that's where I'm putting down my color. Just going back in and blending it out. The bunny is so cute. And the Memento Tuxedo Black Ink that I used is a Copic-friendly ink. It dries rather quickly. So it's perfect for Copic blending. And here we have YR14. Oops. That's my darkest color, Y15 and Y38 to do the boots. And again, lazy with the dots, I'm just gonna color over them and use my gel pen like I did in the last video just to kinda cover those dots. And that YR14 isn't a typical color that I would have grabbed with these yellows. I tend to usually stay fairly close in the family range, but that, when I used my hex chart from Sandy Alnock, the YR14 was actually in close relation to the Y38. So I thought, well, let's give it a shot and see. I really like how it turned out, honestly. I think that that is a good color combination, the YR38 and the YR14. The Y38 and the YR14. And I apologize, I did not zoom in. I wish I had done that. I wasn't thinking, I just got into card making mode and wasn't really paying a close attention to the filming. And once again, just going back over to dry and darken up. And you'll see in the pictures that it ended up being okay. And now I'm grabbing some pinks for the flowers and the bunny nose. Those pinks are RV02 and RV14. As I've said before, these are alcohol-based markers, and so they stay wet for a little bit, and so that's where the blendability comes in. If you don't wait too long, those colors tend to just kind of almost blend on their own. Blending it out. And then I'm going to move on to my greens here after I get the bunny nose and his little ears. And those greens would be YG23 and YG05. I started with my YG23 as my lighter color and went over it with the YG05, which isn't typically what I would do because of the color families, the way they work, but that YG05 is a bit darker, so I thought, let's give it a try. It's not as stark as the last time I colored this image, but I ended up liking it as well. And now I'm moving on to the browns, which is E44 and E49 for the dirt. You know, we don't need rain boots here in El Paso. It doesn't rain a whole lot. So I don't own any. But those are cute. I like that yellow with the white polka dots. We actually don't see a lot of grass here either. It's the desert. And now I've grabbed my white gel pen. And that's the Uniball Signo white gel pen. You're just filling in all those dots, give it some highlights. And there they are. And then I will fussy cut them out, leaving a small border. But I've moved on and I have grabbed the Cartabella Spring Market stickers, and it has that hello there. So I thought, well, I'll just grab that off the stickers. I'm going to put that on the front of my card, and I am going to stick my images just in between those two grass levels with some multimedia matte liquid glue. I don't want a whole lot of dimension on the inside, so I'm just going to stick everything down flat, and I'll put my bunny on the second panel. But that wasn't enough. I had off screen had stamped and colored that little carrot, and I put it down. And here I'm using my beloved stamp platform again, and I'm using the I Love You stamp from that Showers and Flowers. And I'm gonna use the Memento Tuxedo Black Ink again and stamp it down a couple times. That's what makes the stamp platform so fantastic, is that, you know, if you don't get good coverage the first time, just stamp it again. And I've grabbed out now some sequins. I have the Pretty Pink Posh Sparkling Clear 4mm and 6mm sequins that I'm just putting in a little dish that I found at Target for a buck, just to keep them in line. And I've grabbed my Crystal Katana. And because I've used, you know, I've been doing this for years, I typically will go ahead and put my glue dots down where I want them. I know there are people that position their sequins first, and on occasion I'll do that too, but here I'm just putting the glue right on down, and then I'll grab the sequins that I want and stick those down. The Crystal Katana is actually an investment to get one of those, but I do love it. And then, I know you probably wouldn't typically put some on the inside, but I went ahead and did it anyway, because I just thought on the front wasn't enough. So I put down a few more dots of glue and finished it off. I hope you learned something today. If you have any questions, go ahead and leave those down in the comments below, or become a subscriber, like my page. That's how I'll get noticed and maybe even make more of these. But I'm having a good time, so thank you so much for stopping by.